If you think your mashed potato recipe needs an upgrade, this silky and creamy potato puree is just the thing. Potato purees may sound simple, but there are a few tricks to achieving a rich, velvety, smooth texture. And today I'll be pureeing russet potatoes from Idaho with brown butter and cream. And the result, well, it is smooth and glorious. So peel your russet potatoes. We need 3 pounds of potato. And the reason we're using this kind of potato is because they're dry when they cook. And you want a dry, not waxy kind of potato for the smoothest, silkiest purees. And this should just be cut into pieces of a uniform size. So basically in half again, and then in pieces. Have a large kettle fitted with a steamer basket and water in the bottom. You can see what I'm talking about here. I love these steamer baskets. They are so, so useful in the kitchen. Very essential for all kinds of vegetable cookery and potatoes. Well, they steam very well. Now, if you were adverse to peeling your potatoes, you can steam whole potatoes, 3 pounds, right in here. They'll take a little longer, but they work very, very well. So now cover and let steam until very tender to the point of a sharp knife. Now, the next step is to make your brown butter. 1½ sticks of butter over a low flame until the milk solids in the butter turn a nutty brown. It takes a little while, but this will impart a really amazing flavor to your potato puree. And in a strainer fitted with a little piece of cheesecloth, add 2 cloves of garlic and about 6 sprigs of thyme. Your brown butter is going to be passed right through this, and the butter then will taste a little bit like garlic, a little bit like thyme, and a lot like brown butter. So here is our brown butter. It is a really nice, nutty brown color. Pour this butter over the garlic. Hear the crackling? And over the thyme. And add your 1½ cups of heavy cream. All of this into a saucepan. Now heat this up, because this is the liquid with which your potato puree will be thinned and smoothed. Press out all the goodness. The infusion of the garlic and thyme in the butter and cream seems like such a little thing, but it really makes a difference. So I'll leave this on low while I smooth the potatoes. So the potatoes are done. Take the entire steamer basket out and just let them sit for a minute or two, just to cool off slightly. You don't want them cold for the next step, because we're going to just gently mash them, breaking them up a little bit so that we can then push them through a strainer. Now, you can use a food mill, which acts sort of like a ricer. A ricer, you put the potatoes in and the potatoes come out in little pieces all the way around. Or you could use a tamis, which is a classic French tool that you use to smooth out any kinds of purees. And this is a little too fine for what we're doing, but these chinois come in different textures also, and you could probably use that if you have one. But I find that pretty much everybody has strainers of different gauge screen. This is about a 32nd of an inch screen, and this goes down to much smaller than that, maybe a 64th of an inch screen. Very fine. This is our last pass through. So start with your potatoes. Just put them in a bowl. And now the russets, I am just mashing, and to make all of this go through the strainer quickly, you can add about 1 cup of your milk and cream mixture. Now, that's not traditional, and French chefs out there, don't get mad at me, but we find that it just works faster. And I think we don't want to make it hard on our home cooks. These are lessons for the home cook. So I will add, a scoop, maybe a scoop and a half. Now this is the old fashioned potato masher. Sundays before the chicken or the pot roast or the roast beef came out of the oven, this was my job to make the smoothest, most delicious mashed potatoes ever with this. I wasn't happy with the result. It was always a little bit lumpy. That's why we've elaborated on a technique, and we're going to put this now through the strainer. Now, very, very important, don't think that you can use a food processor or a blender. They are way too vigorous and will make glue out of your potatoes. They cause too much starch to release and a gluey texture results. But look what's coming out, a very fine textured puree. This now goes right into the finer strainer. So you see, this is the last of the potato to come through the sieve. And it is really good. Now it's time to mix the potatoes with the brown butter, garlic, thyme, cream, and milk mixture. A ladle at a time. Takes a little while for the potatoes to absorb this cream. It seems like a lot of liquid, but these purees are delicate and they are moist, and you don't want them to be stiff and dry in any way. I'm going to add some salt right now, coarse salt. This is going to take about a teaspoon of salt and a big pinch of white pepper. Now, if you wish, you could add a hint of nutmeg. There you have it. Put this on a heated platter. So good. The brown butter sauce makes these potatoes hard to resist. Don't even try.